I'm Burke Holland.
I'm Jasmine Greenaway.
And this is a giant Jenga tower. And we're going to play Jenga and give you five reasons why you should check out and use Cosmos DB. Thing number one, Cosmos DB, in case you didn't know, is a NoSQL database. So when we say NoSQL, what exactly does that mean?
We just pretty much mean that it's non-relational, and you have what you would call normally a table is pretty much now a collection. It's a collection of documents, and so these documents have all of your what you would call fields or columns, and there are actually properties in each of these documents.
So it's just a different kind of database. It's not a table with different rows and columns, but rather a bunch of documents that are stored instead. This tower's gonna fall. You're doomed.
No.
Nope. She got it. Wow. Okay. Right. Thing number two, Cosmos DB is multi-API, which is kind of weird when it comes to a database. What does multi-API mean?
Well, it pretty much means that even though the documents and the structure of documents stay the same, you can pretty much use either, you can query with either SQL or MongoDB, Cassandra, Gremlin. It's all up to you. And so you pretty much, you model your data the way you want, and you just query with the tools that you know and love, and the queries that or the query language that you know and love.
Right, so you can use SQL, or you could use the MongoDB API. Mm-hmm. And one of the things that you had explained to me that was very interesting that I not realized, that one of the reasons why you might use a document database instead of a traditional relational database is that modeling data from a relational database kind of stinks sometimes. Like, it's kind of hard.
Yes.
But modeling with NoSQL, very easy.
Yes, it's super, super easier. Like, so as a .NET dev, traditionally, I work with like SQL a lot. And for me, it's sometimes hard to model your class models against your database. And so using Cosmos DB, all I have to do is just, I don't need any extra packages. All I need is the Cosmos API and my Cosmos DB instance, and I'm ready to
go.
Right.
So if you have a user object with all these nested fields in it, like you know, address, people they know, things like that, you can just stuff that whole object in the database, and we need it again, pull it back out again. NoSQL's pretty cool. For all my JavaScript people out there, you probably already know what it is. You probably already worked with it. We're going to give you some links in the notes below to check out more about NoSQL in general to help you out in case you need it. Thing number three, Cosmos DB, one of the strengths that it has is that it's globally distributed. And I can't wait for you to knock this whole tower down.
No, I will not. Watch this.
One of the things that I've learned about this tower is that you can't pull from the bottom because these are 2x4s and this thing weighs a ton.
Yeah, these
blocks
are super heavy.
You cannot move it from the bottom.
Yeah.
It's like an unplayable game of Jenga. So when we say globally distributed, what we mean is that Azure has a few data centers, like a lot of data centers. And that means that your users may be all over the world. So they may be in India, they may be in the United States, they may be in Australia, they could be in China, they could be anywhere. And the closer that your data is to those people, to those users, the faster their experience is gonna be. And so Cosmos DB allows you to replicate your database instantly around the globe, just with the click of a button. So actually in the Azure portal, there's this cool little map and it has all the data center locations. And if you want to replicate your data, you just click on the data center location and it lights up and it's ready to go, which is really, really neat. That's a very cool feature, especially if you're working with a globally distributed set of users.
Right, exactly. And a nice thing about that is you can actually configure the access, the way that these regions access the data. So maybe you have like a read-only or write-only or read and write type of permissions that you want to give a certain region. That's all up to you, and you can actually do that within the portal as well.
That's pretty cool. You know what you can't do is pull a block out from this Jenga tower, because I've been trying. This one right here, it's painted in. This whole game is a lie. Ooh, I got this one. Watch this.
Go for it.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
I'm gonna win.
All right, you say so. Watch this.
Oh my gosh.
Up in the stakes here.
Oh, Jasmine. Oh my gosh!
I don't think that's cheating, I think. I think I just cheated.
It's fine. Just put it on this side of the tower. I didn't see anything. Just don't touch it. I'm scared to death.
I'm a rebel.
If this thing falls over, it's gonna knock this building down.
It's gonna
be seriously loud.
Yeah, the echoes.
Let's do
it. Really loud.
Thing number four, and probably my favorite feature of Cosmos DB, is that you can query it right from VS Code. This is amazing because when you work with your database, what you really want is to work with your data right where your code is. You don't want to have to go out to some other admin tool. You want to just be right there in your editor. And with the VS Code extension for Cosmos DB, you can do that.
So with the Cosmos DB extension, you can have access to all of your Cosmos DB instances and go ahead and run your queries with that. But the also really cool thing is that you can actually connect to your MongoDB instances in your data in your MongoDB collections and query through that. So you don't even need a Cosmos DB account to actually use the extension.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. So for all you JavaScript people out there using MongoDB, if you want to use your MongoDB database and query it right from VS Code, you can do that with the Cosmos DB extension. We'll put a link to that in the show notes below. Thing number five, for all our Azure people out there, Cosmos DB is just one click away for you. So there's no point in installing a VM, or you can install Mongo on a VM, you can install some NoSQL solution, but Cosmos DB, you don't have to install anything, you can just click and go.
Yes, and the nice thing is not only that you can use it with like your applications, like whether like you know mobile or web, you can actually set it up with like things like serverless. So for example, you can set up a function trigger that does something when somebody inserts a new document into your collection or things like that.
Right, so, which is really powerful, all the cloud services glued together. We'll put a link in the notes below as well so you can see how to use write a serverless function rather that talks directly to Cosmos DB via the Cosmos bindings.
Yeah.
Nice. All right, one more block and then we're done.
Okay, well, it's your turn.
I'm Burke Cullen.
I'm Jasmine Greenaway.
And this is our giant Jenga tower, and now you know five reasons that you should check out and probably use Azure Cosmos DB. And I'm about to win this game. Oh gosh! It went right for you.